Shut up, smirks. Reroll, Redux. No, I won't tap out. I won't tap out. All of you butthurts suck. Just stop watching Raw. Stop watching Raw. This is Fabo Mark Gervone. You are listening to a pre-preview and paper review free episode of Ring Rust, now part of the Club Kayfabe creative community. So, what I'm going to be doing today, since I don't have any shows to preview or review, I'm going to be pitting Wrestle Crap against Kayfabe News and see who comes out on top. Spoilers, it's me. So, we're starting off with some headlines from Wrestle Crap. WWE Studios announced that their latest movie will feature WWE superstar Braun Strowman in the lead role of their new romantic comedy, I'm Not Finished With You. Strowman, whose popularity has risen in recent months thanks to being portrayed as an unstoppable monster, will be taking on the role of Biff Strongman, a professional wrestler that is a monster in the ring and a sweetheart out of it. His love interest in the movie will be the star of Grey's Anatomy and Knocked Up, Katherine Heigl. She plays upright and overall unpleasant sports reporter Susan Plex. Ha! Suplex. I can't break this stuff because they already wrote it. After messing up a story that caused the local sports team to lose the championship, Plex is demoted to covering professional wrestling. Well, I oughta. Soon, she comes to appreciate Strongman, or Strongman, maybe, I don't know, and the wonderful world of wrestling. It's actually an interesting story about how the movie came about, said WWE CEO and the movie's writer, Vince McMahon. I was looking at a breakdown of our demographics and screams, what do women want? Well, that caused my Alexa, that Stephanie got me for my birthday, to list all sports, all sorts of things. Makeup, clothes, that sort of thing. So Alexa is a thing, yeah, that they had Alexa Bliss setting it off several months ago, quote-unquote famously. I yelled, Alexa, what do men want to shut up? And Heigl's name popped right up. A weekend hold up in a hotel room with nothing to eat but protein shakes and Mary Callender chicken pot pies and vodka, and voila, pure cinematic gold, unquote. Now, he didn't say some of the stuff that I was saying. That's me interjecting, so, because I was figuring things out as I was reading it. It's really a beautiful story, said Strowman. It's nice to be able to stretch my acting abilities. I'm actually an incredible dancer and can't wait to shoot the scene where my elaborate dance moves win back Susan's heart. I'm going to smooch her so good, unquote. I endorse this movie and or product, said a letter provided by Heigl's agent. It's a tale of love, loss, and leg locks. I came up with that tagline myself, said Strowman proudly. While there are no plans yet to release I'm Not Finished With You in theaters, WWE officials have said that the movie will be shown on all Southwest Airlines flights. So, yeah, I'm winning so far. But, you know, I feel like I might weaken sometime during this, so I'm just going to have to hope that I'm stronger.
The Club Kayfabe Creative Community. Bringing together creative people from all walks of life and giving them a platform to show off their talents. Podcasters, artists, cosplayers, authors. Check out all the information about Club Kayfabe Creative Community at ckcconline.com.
So, next we're going over to Kayfabe News. Extreme Championship Wrestling earned a reputation in the 90s as a gritty, hard-hitting renegade promotion full of violent misfits, but you'd be surprised how many of them went on to win the Nobel Prize. Well, I'd be surprised if more than one did, or even one did. Here's a look at the ECW Originals, who, despite repeated chair shots and falls to the syphilitic floor of the Philadelphia Bingo Hall, subsequently become some of the world's most respected academics. Although he was best known as a cigarette-smoking, beer-swilling, kendo-stick-wielding maniac within the ropes of the ECW ring, Sandman, real name Sandy Mann, spent much of his spare time writing feminist poetry in the vein of Sylvia Plath and Alice Walker. His best-known work, Exit Light, Enter Night, was recognized by the 2011 Nobel Prize in Literature for, quote, a rich and intensive prose, which with which with restrained compassion forms a challenging vision of man's vulnerability. Unquote. Did you ever wonder why the homicidal, genocidal, and suicidal maniac spent so much time pointing towards the sky? Despite his reputation as a bloodthirsty sadist who sacrificed his own body to destroy others, Sabu, real name Sir Terence J. Brunk III, earned his doctorate in astrophysics before ever setting foot in the wrestling ring. He earned a 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics for his, quote, development of the heliotropic interferometer for measuring neutrino oscillation and for sick table bumps, unquote. Although he did not achieve the same level of fame as his half-brothers Devon and Bubba, the late Big Dick Dudley, real name Richard Dudley, was clearly the most intelligent of the Dudleys, having transitioned from ECW to a professorship at Harvard Medical School, where he conducted Nobel-winning research into ionic mechanisms involved in excitation and inhibition of the peripheral and central portions in human male genitalia, now known as Big Dick Syndrome. Despite his reputation as a local luchador, Super Crazy, real name Bob Smith, was anything but crazy. In fact, his Nobel-winning advances in neurochemistry led to the treatment and cure of countless forms of mental illness, including the peculiar mental defect that makes some otherwise normal people watch and enjoy professional wrestling. I take offense to that. Often regarded as the most dangerous, reckless competitor to step inside a wrestling ring, New Jack is notorious for nearly killing numerous opponents. But since his ECW heyday, New Jack, real name Jerome LaFonda Young, has a shrewd violence for harmony. He won the 2014 Nobel Peace Prize for his work to, quote, end homelessness worldwide, particularly among female dogs and promiscuous ladies who sound like garden instruments. In an upcoming movie about his life, New Jack will be portrayed by Denzel Washington, while New Jack himself will portray Denzel's best friend. Yeah, that sounds about right, I guess. Most wrestling fans don't realize that Perry Saturn is the namesake of the planet Saturn, which he discovered as an astronomy grad student at Berkeley in the late 80s. He later won a Nobel for the discovery and celebrated the honor by getting himself a very classy face tattoo. And finally, according to former ECW honcho Paul Heyman, everyone knew Ian Rotten was a genius. You could tell just by looking at him, unquote. Pro wrestling was always just a sociological experiment to Rotten, real name Dr. Emmanuel J. Farnsworth, Ph.D., who is the only person to have ever won a Nobel Prize in every category. His famous Taipei death match against his brother Axel was, he once wrote, a, quote, dramatic embodiment of the human condition and the eternal struggle between idealism, solipsism, I hope, and nihilism. And here we all thought it was just extreme. You are listening to Ring Rust Redux on Gerbronology TV. This is Fanboy Mark Gerbroni. You are listening to the Wrestle Crap versus Kayfabe News edition of Ring Rust, now part of the Club Kayfabe creative community. Back to Wrestle Crap. They actually announced a new induction as of August 24th. The Divas Pajama Pillow Fight. Far more dangerous than it sounds. I guess it would kind of have to be. So, WWE 2012. This past weekend, the WWE Universe... No, I can't do that. I don't care how many times the company tries to shove that gibberish down our throats, it always sounds completely idiotic. Why can't we just be wrestling fans? Seriously, think about that. Why can't we be pro wrestling fans because WWE won't allow the words pro wrestling or fans to be uttered? What sense does that make? Hey, thanks for showing up, kid. I'm going to be mentioning you in just a few minutes. But first, let me get back to the issue of ramblings. So it's a little bit of a, yeah. Do I want to read the whole thing? Yeah, sure, why not? So the kid I think in reference is AJ Lee, so I guess we'll be, anyway. So this is by K.R.D. Reynolds, the, you know, proprietor of WrestleCrap. When he was going to mention the really fun match between Asuka and Ember Moon on NXT. While he's never been a huge fan of Ember, she's all right, just don't think she's great. Asuka has been tremendous since she joined the fun. To be fair, it wasn't like Ember dragged the match down. She stayed in there just fine. It was a great encounter and made him very glad that he took time out of his schedule to watch it. Of course, his head shaking with for the so-called Divas Revolution in WWE is well documented. And he was far from the only one. As readers of this here site deemed it a co-winner of the 2015 Gukor Award, you can read the induction here by clicking on that link on the RussellCrop.com article that I'm reading from right now. Still, while it took longer than they'd hoped, the women of the WWE have been able to turn a corner somewhat and make women's wrestling more than something you either gawked at or, worse, ignored completely, using it as a bathroom break timeout at events. It wasn't that long ago that things were radically different, you know. As he was doing research for this induction to prove that very point, he decided to go back 5 years to see what was happening with the women in WWE. Want to know what he found? The red carpet dressed to impress Battle Royal, apparently, was what he found. This amazing spectacle featured the women of the company dressed as if they were heading to prom and kicked off with Rosa Mendez attempting to figure out how to fling herself over the top rope. Always good, so yeah, anyway. Bouncing back and forth in the process as if she were made of rubber. She then landed on the floor in such a manner that made it appear she'd broken every bone in her body. And then there's the Diva Bowl. He remembers very early in the formation of WrestleCrap.com, he decided that one of the first inductions would be the Idiotic Raw Bowl. And if you have archive access, you can find that by clicking that link there. Cost money for the archive, but anyway. A train wreck that featured the likes of Billy Gunn and Savio Vega battling for the Steve Lombardi Trophy. One moment, please. Fast forward nearly 20 years, and we get women dressed in football outfits doing the same thing, stomping their feet, running at each other, and falling down in a crumpled mess. I'm pretty sure Mickie James was offsides as well. Ref, why didn't you throw a flag? Where's Ed Hooch-Cooley? I don't know that name. Or the ladies' man Jerome Boger when you need them. On the plus side, we got Rosa. What does that deal with her starting these matches? Channeling her inner Danielson, going all crane technique, and getting kicked right smack dab in the face. Can't duck that match solely on principle for that spot. And in the summer months of 2012, we got the Bikini Battle Royal, designed pretty much for the ground up so that the company would fat shame the very great Vicky Guerrero. So we're now getting great stuff in NXT from Asuka, and pretty darn good encounters on the main roster from the likes of Becky Lynch, Charlotte, and others. Well, it's a far cry from the garbage we were force-fed just scant years ago. I mean, now, he doesn't think you're going to flip to SmackDown next Tuesday to get a pajama pillow fight, but we did in 2010. March 1st, to be exact. This would be during the infamous celebrity guest host era in Raw. Sure, that still happens now and again, but there are times when it seemed every single week that WWE found someone, anyone with name value in the past 8 decades to show up and play GM for the night. On this particular evening, our guest host would be 1970s potheads Cheech and Chong. In the midst of writing this induction, it has struck the author that it is very wrong they've never actually put that entire episode on the site. Rest assured, RD will correct that in the very near future. During a Lucky Charms acid trip, really, that was the short show-long storyline, the two made their way out to ringside to catch this special encounter. No doubt, you newer fans may believe that he's exaggerating and this was a pillow fight. He's not. This is exactly what it was billed to be. The girls get into the ring and proceed to smack each other in the heads with pink bags of fluff, which would be altogether different from the pink bags of fluff that Vicky assaulted AJ with in the bikini match that he mentioned above. In this particular brawl, we got the WWE lady folk attempting to do physical damage utilizing honest-to-goodness pillows, just like the one you lay your feeble head upon when you go to sleep. As he watched the opening seconds, he began to ponder. Just how many times would you need to hit somebody with a pillow before they physically collapse to the mat, enabling you to get a 1-2-3? Would 3 hours be enough? Thankfully, we didn't get to wait to find out, as your friend and mine, Jillian Hall, threw the pillows aside and just started clotheslining everyone in sight. So, no appreciation for Jillian. The greatest horrible gimmick ever, terrible singer who can't stop bellowing out pop songs, and you make it work. RD never considered his Christmas season to be complete unless he'd heard her heartwarming version of Jingle Bell Rock complete with flatulent tubas tooting out the bass line. Unfortunately, Jillian's concert here is disrupted by an obviously jealous Kelly Kelly, who attempts to smother her with his hero with a pillow. She follows that up with whatever that move is in that GIF that's playing on WrestleCrap.com. I mean, you know, you get this attack of sorts on Jillian's back, but Kelly looks so daggum skinny, it's surprising that Jillian didn't just stay there perched up on all fours upon impact. Regardless, it only gets to two count, and then Kelly is immediately attacked by Maryse. Yes, that Maryse, with a DDT or whatever the heck that's supposed to be. All I can say for certain is that it looks to have broken Kelly's neck. What is it with giving these largely untrained women moves that could result in serious damage? Why don't you just give them a sleeper or as a finisher? You could call it the Maryse, because of the Z's. Eventually, Gail Kim hits a sweet neck breaker, one so swell that the author cannot in good conscience include this in the induction. Following the show of athletic ability, she goes for a pin on Maryse, when they have victory snatched away by being hit with a pillow. Eve Torres enters the fray, attacking Gail from behind. She sends her flying with the ring courtesy of a drop kick that misses by a good foot and a half. Hey, at least she didn't legit clock her in the back of the skull with her feet. I'll take whatever positives I can at this point. And in keeping with RD's new Pollyanna attitude, he won't even bring up that he has zero idea what on earth this flipping double leg drop thing that Eve is doing is supposed to be. Instead, he'll focus on the positive, namely that it caused the match to end. Also, props to Alicia for wearing bunny slippers into the ring. Oh yeah, the next time you want to start chanting boring during a women's match on Raw, you think is going to be a little too long or whatever, consider that we used to get and count yourself lucky. Or just watch a Nia Jax kills another poor girl and hang your head in shame. You're listening to Ring Rust Redux on Gerbronology TV.
Hey, what's up? This is referee Tony S., and you're listening to Ring Rust on CHMR.
Excellent.
Ew, my inside!
After being trounced by John Cena in a war of words this past Monday on WWE Raw, Roman Reigns has fired back with a volley of verbal zingers, including, I know you are, but what am I? And poo on you. Reigns took to Twitter after reportedly spending the past 48 hours consulting a copy of Mad Magazine's Compendium of Snappy Comebacks. Among Roman's more notable rebuffs, hey, at John Cena, you suck. Stamped it, no erases. And hey, at John Cena, if you love WWE so much, why don't you marry it? And I think at John Cena is the greatest WWE superstar ever not. And hustle, loyalty, respect, more like schmoshal, schmoyalty, schmispect. Hashtag zing. And listen, at John Cena, I think you are sick, really great, no opposites, on opposites day. And at John Cena is always saying, you can't see me, I wish I couldn't see him because he is so ugly. Yeah. Reigns, reportedly embarrassed by the verbal beatdown he suffered at the hands of the Doctor of Thugonomics, is also reportedly planning to reinvent himself in several subtle ways. For example, this coming Monday on Raw, he's expected to reveal his doctorate in advanced thugonometry and unveil his new catchphrase, your eyes don't work. Cause... okay, then. You're listening to Ring Rust Redux on Gerbronology TV.
Doesn't own an oven, microwave, or stove, as revenge is a dish best served cold. And the original draft of The Lord of the Rings featured the Macho Man. It was only 5 pages long, as Savage top rope elbow dropped Sauron's arse halfway through the first chapter. On Facebook, tinyurl.com/ringrust. Follow me on Twitter,
at Mark Jabroni, and subscribe to Jabronology TV, youtube.com/fanboymarkjabroni.
This is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You're listening to the Kayfabe News versus Wrestle Crap edition of Ring Rust, now part of the Club Kayfabe community. So, Brooklyn, New York, WWE superstar Baron Corbin has developed a new persona in light of recent events. Corbin, who has been acting strangely since failing to cash in his Money in the Bank contract on SmackDown, appeared backstage sporting a new white streak in his suddenly bushy hair. "Delicious," exclaimed the wide-eyed Corbin while getting a meal at catering. "This truly is the most exquisite baked chicken and fruit salad in all the land. The rumblings of my tum-tum have been silenced." Unquote. "He really freaked me out this morning when he introduced me to his son Maxwell," said Kofi Kingston. "It was just a Maxwell House coffee can." "Corbin's brain is now full on booty," said Big E. "There's no cure for booty brain. His hair totally uggo, but so uggo that fans are totally going to love it," said Tyler Breeze. "Now if only he can do something about his face, chest, arms, legs, and smell." "We're all a bit concerned about Baron," said Stephanie McMahon. "Failing to cash in has hit him really hard." Things became stranger when Corbin ran into his SummerSlam opponent, John Cena. "Brother John-o," hollered Corbin across the dining area. "Though we may have exchanged fists at SummerSlam, soon will be our winter of discontent." "Man, I'm just here to get some of that baked chicken. Rumor has it it's good," said Cena. "It's delicious, you fool. You will now be defeated for such insolence." "Defeat! Defeat! Defeat!" screamed Corbin. "Madlinks won, attack." Corbin then proceeded to throw paper airplanes at Cena before heading back to his studio apartment. He now dubs the Corbin Compound. WWE officials are currently unsure how to deal with the newly broken Baron Corbin, but have confirmed that they have not spoken with Matt Hardy about it. Most definitely have not spoken to Matt Hardy. No, definitely not. Because, no. And, no.
You are listening to Ring Rust Redux on Jabronology TV.
Marge, it takes two to lie. One to lie and one to listen.
What does that mean?
No!
Oh, moving! Ow, pointy!
You slimy.
Woohoo!
Now back to the Kayfabe News versus Wrestle Crap. So, just days after the much-hyped boxing match between Floyd Money Mayweather and Conor Hornswoggle McGregor, the contract has been signed for the duo to face one another at WrestleMania, insists a disheveled man who won't leave us alone at the TGI Fridays bar in the Buffalo International Airport. "Seriously, this is totally going to happen at WrestleMania in New Orleans," confirmed the reeking, bleary-eyed man who claims he, quote, "knows somebody who knows somebody," unquote, backstage at WWE. "And this time McGregor's going to win because he, like, you know, got screwed the first time. It's going to be a hell of a match, too, for real, mark my words." WWE's neither confirmed nor denies reports from the besotted man, which can only assume is a tacit admission from the company that the rumors are indeed true. The blotchy and bloated man, whose goddamn plane in Mississippi was delayed by several hours, apparently has a number of very well-connected sources backstage at WWE, as he also revealed, one, the first Ultimate Warrior is still alive but hiding from the government because he knows too much, and the infamous Montreal screwjob was fake like the moon landings, and the Undertaker's streak is only broken because Vince McMahon is a scared Lesnar. And John Cena will turn heel this week. This is going to happen. The man dashed to the restroom to vomit before he could be asked his name, but a luggage tag in his suitcase revealed P. Patterson. I wonder what that could mean. Well, anyway, I'm sure whoever books that for WrestleMania, they got money.
Me on Facebook, tinyurl.com/ringrust. Follow me on Twitter at Mark Jabroni, and subscribe to Jabronology TV. YouTube.com/fanboymarkjabroni.
This is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You're listening to the Kayfabe Oka. What now? If I can have your attention, please. I just received an email from the ridiculous Ring Rush Yellow Manager. Do I have time for this? That's exactly the question he's asking me. Do I have time to do this and play a song? Well, I guess we're going to find out, aren't we? Well, let's see. Ask the Magic Smart Ball. Do I have time, since we're into wasting it, do I have time to read the next induction and the next selection here from WrestleCrap.com and play a song? Kick out at 2. So, no, I guess I don't. Thanks. But, okay then. I guess what I'm going to do then, because it is a bit of a long, I'm going to be reading another WrestleCrap induction. So, yeah, it's probably a good idea just to introduce you to it and then listen to the song, and then you can read the rest of the article if you're so inclined. WWE 1987. The author, R.D. Reynolds, had been binging primetime wrestling on the network of late. I mean, not that it's anything new to him. He's long made known his love for this television program, but he won't bore you with the details about it again. He binged long before the network existed on good old-fashioned VHS tapes he recorded from the original earrings, and long before the term binge existed for watching junk over and over. He's not going to tell you that it's required viewing for anyone visiting this site, but he's done it a zillion times. You either get it by now, or you are a hopeless loser who never will. Suffice to say, he's nearing the end of 1987, which means each and every week, Gorilla is here to shill this little item. Namely, Pile Driver, the wrestling album, too. Man, that brings back memories. Not only memories of when he first saw the thing hit the air, but fond recollections of when he first started this website. From day one, he knew one of the first articles he was going to pen would cover Pile Driver. How could it not? It was the epitome of WrestleCrap, what the site was designed to be about. It had been several years since he looked at the original induction on the article on the archives, which you can access with that link right there. He was kind of curious what he'd written about the video, so he went to the Wayback and discovered what he wrote up. What's better than talking about the Pile Driver video than going on over to YouTube and watching the Pile Driver video? From Pile Driver, the wrestling album too, this is WWE Hall of Famer, Coco Beware. Yes, he's in the Hall of Fame. With Pile Driver.
that's it for another show, kiddies. Check me out on Facebook, where you can keep track of all the news that's right on the mark, from around ringside to the latest concerts. See you at the shows. Later days.
This is 93.5 CHMR FM.